Thank you. To your seats, the ceremony will begin shortly.
Thank you.
Good evening. Everyone, please find your seats as we are about to start the ceremony. At this time, we request that you turn your cellular devices to silent mode. Please be aware that this event has a no re-entry policy. Once you leave the building, you will not be permitted to re-enter. Please note that our professional photographer will take a picture of each graduate with their diploma. There is no access to the floor area during the entirety of the ceremony. We will be beginning our ceremony shortly. Thank you. For this year's commencement, our school has incorporated the use of cedar boughs in our archway. Cedar has deep spiritual and cultural significance to the local indigenous communities that spans thousands of years. It continues to be used in ceremony in many different ways, including over archways like this. It is considered to be a cleanser that can clear a path and help to leave bad feelings behind. We honor these teachings by incorporating cedar here today, and we invite you to think of what that could mean as you move forward in the next stage of your life. We ask that you please remain seated as the graduates enter the auditorium. So hopefully somebody has cued.
Well, it's up to them now.
Yeah.
They're coming.
I could just say that again. And we're asking to remain seated as the graduates enter the auditorium.
Nope.
I will need to at some point. Thank you. Welcome, graduating class of 2023. I think that I can safely say, on behalf of all of the staff at Sarda Secondary School and friends and community members and relatives in the audience, we are very excited and pleased to be a part of your evening. Thank you. At this time, I would like to call to the stage Chief Derek Epp.
That was awesome.
Aswell, Wililik Telskweed, Talitza Kwachi Actil. Good evening, everybody. My traditional name is Wililik. My given name is Derek Epp. I'm the chief of Chiactin First Nation, which is part of the Chilkwaek Tribe and the Greater Stalo Nation. On behalf of Chiactin First Nation, the Chilkwaek Tribe, I want to welcome each and every one of you here tonight to the 2023 Sarda Secondary Commencement Evening, which is being hosted in the traditional territory of the Chilkwaek Tribe and the Palalt Tribe, which is part of the Stalo Nation. It's a really exciting evening for all of you. It's pretty cool to see all the grads, all the excitement. It's hard to believe I've been sitting in your chairs about 15 years ago. And you know, it's really an honor to be here tonight, welcoming you all to your graduation ceremony. I really enjoy doing these events, listening to the excitement in the room, and really listening to all the buzz that goes on in these in your final days of high school. And it's really exciting. I think you guys are really the changers of our society, the movers and shakers, this next generation. And I'm really excited to see you guys and what you're going to achieve. It really was cool to see a lot of the Indigenous regalia as well coming out, seeing some of the cedar hats, seeing some of the Métis representation as well, and really honoring who we are as Tsleil-Waututh people and who we are as Indigenous people in this country we call Canada. So really just want to welcome you all here tonight. Enjoy the evening. And really just a quick message to the grads. You know, I said, you know, I was in your shoes 15 years ago. And I really, if I would have been sitting where you are right now, I would have shook my head and laughed at you if you would have told me that I would have been the chief of my community and would be up here welcoming you to your grad ceremonies. So I just want to encourage you to be courageous. Be brave. Take on challenges. Open the doors when they come to you. And don't be afraid to smash right through it and go after things. Make change. That's what this is all about, our new society. So really take those opportunities. Make sure you face them head on. There's going to be challenges. You're going to learn lessons. You're going to screw up. But really do your best to learn, to listen, and to keep pushing forward. And I know you guys are going to be doing some amazing things, and not just here in Chilliwack, but across this province, country, and this world. So really want to acknowledge you and just raise my hands to you and congratulate you on making it and being here and being committed to the process. And without further ado, I really want to just thank the Palalt Canoe family as well, and specifically Tyrell Williams. She's been working with me over the last couple weeks to make sure that we incorporate a bit of her culture into these ceremonies. This is our fourth together so far, so it's been great to work with the Palalt Canoe family to bring a bit of our culture into this. And I'm going to ask that they come up to the stage and just welcome us with a few songs as well. So just enjoy the evening, everybody, and thank you for allowing me to open it up in a good way. Thanks, everybody. They're going to do one more song, and feel free to stay seated for this next one as well. It's okay. And really want to just acknowledge again the Palalt Canoe family, and just a reminder that each of these songs do tell a bit of a story about who we are. And really, I want to acknowledge you guys for all standing as well and being so respectful. But yeah, please stay seated for the next one. Thank you. Thanks again, and thanks to the Palalt Canoe family for sharing a bit of our culture. Enjoy the night, everybody, and congratulations to the grads.
Thank you, Chief Derek Epp and the Palalt Canoe family, for beginning this work and celebration in a good and heartfelt way. We are excited to move forward with our night and with open hearts and minds. It is our pleasure to welcome you to our 57th annual commencement ceremony.
Yes, and my name is Kevin Beagle.
And I am Kevin Siggity, and we will be your masters of ceremony this evening. We were pleased to be able to step in at the last minute, as unfortunately Kevin Wilenchenko and Kevin Gamble became unavailable.
Yeah. Too many Kevins around this place. As a school, we celebrate our grads and recognize in each of them Huem Kemestas Stimit, which means to meet with all of one's efforts in Halkomelem. Congratulations to each member of the graduating class of 2023.
Mm-hmm. At this time, I would like to call Amaya Gonzalez, Sam Dong, and Kevin Beagle to the stage. With the exception of our graduates, we ask those with hats to please remove them now for the singing of our national anthem. Please rise and join us in singing, O Canada. Thank you, Amaya, Sam, and Mr. Beagle. Please join me now in welcoming Silas Reimer, who will play a trumpet solo for us, followed by Claire Pickney, who will perform a spoken word poem.
All right. Can I say something? Absolutely. Hello, guys. My name is Silas Reimer. I am graduating nothing cum laude and average scholar. I'm here to play Tico for y'all, so hopefully you enjoy. Thank you.
job.
I think that's you, actually.
Oh, my goodness.
That's a church. Funny. Yeah. So is this me?
Okay, mm-hmm. Is there?
No. Thank you, Claire. Silas, of course. We're asking now Claire to come to the stage.
Hello, my name is Claire. Usually spoken word poetry is done in front of a mic, but I'm going to use this so I have a stand for what I'm reading. But this poem is called More Than Red Ink. Teachers teach us the most when they aren't formally teaching. I had this epiphany, the sum of my scrambled letters that tore across the paper. After throwing up words and wiping them away to start anew, I knew. And it's hard to form the words for several someones you appreciate so much. The English class has forged me as a proficient poet, but I still don't know how to express it when I mean thank you. That's beyond a graded assignment. Our teachers stretch beyond graded assignments. Our teachers go beyond the job description every day. Do you think they're being paid to let us into their lives one story at a time? Yet, I always take the most from these spoken memories like life advice. And the human oddity in their past is a comfort as I grow older. Eating placenta on spaghetti with the boys, reading love poems from a soccer player cheating on his girlfriend, cheesy footfalls with boyfriends long ago in our school halls. We all like to listen more to people we connect with. So these teachers relive high school again and again just so we have a chance out there. And they also talk adulting, sick kids and funerals and sometimes school alongside work, old parents and unfair circumstances that seem kind of absurd, the recovery from the tearing of the body and the mind. Yet my questions still get answered, my hard work gets praised and refined. Teachers define resilience. If your teacher ever weathered your tires before the rain, it was to prepare you for the sleet storm they went through. They make us kick it in the deep end because they know that's where adults swim. I've been taught when to work like a dog and when to rest. I've been taught to fact check my dreamed realities, but still hold hope for what's in front of me. I've been taught connections can shape who I become. And I learned it from a side tangent during biochemistry. When I look past the curriculum, I see pages of mental notes. Maybe I can't define the subordinate clause, but I'll be taking the gifts of shared life experience with me for years. So for the next week, the least we students could do is say thank you as a teacher walks by. Thank you for the hardships, or thank you for the fun times, or both if you have AP calculus. And I'll say thank you because teacher, without you, I wouldn't have survived. Teacher, without you, that compassion, I wouldn't have been wrung dry. Teacher, without you, I'd never have been borderline wrung dry, but I feel more than ready for next time. So teacher, thank you.
Thank you, Claire and Cyrus. Well done, both of you, Claire and Silas. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Sardis Secondary Jazz Band under the direction of Kevin Beagle.
Good evening, everybody. We're going to be doing two pieces for you this evening. The first one is My Calliante, and let's see, that is by, I forget the composer, Eric Sherburn. Yeah, I knew that. And then Los Vientos by Paul Baker. Thank you. And that's Ewan on the piano.
Thank you.
So thank you to the Sardis Secondary School Jazz Band and to Mr. Beagle.
Alrighty. Everyone present looks forward to this special evening with utmost anticipation and excitement. Graduates, families, staff, community members, parents will no doubt find themselves reflecting tonight on those years of school that are culminating with this evening. And I would like to encourage each grad to recall the last 4 years you've had at Sardis Secondary. You've worked hard and accomplished much along the journey to reach this milestone occasion. Please know that your connection to Sardis family does not end here. For once a Falcon! Oh, no, that wasn't good enough. Once a Falcon! You got it, that's right. We hope each of you enjoys the evening as we recognize you, the graduates of 2023.
Yeah. All right.
Please join me this evening as we acknowledge and welcome the following school district and elected dignitaries: Rohan Arul Prayasam, Karen Bondar, Heather Maz, Richard Procy, Willow Rieschelt, David Swanky, and Terry Westerby. I now invite Rohan Arul Prayasam, Superintendent of the Chilliwack School District, to present his message to the Sardis graduating class.
Eholalt, Ekwasami, Rohan Telskwi. Good evening, distinguished guests, elders, parents, friends, staff, and students. It's my pleasure to bring greetings from the team at the Chilliwack Board Office to the graduates. Congratulations. It's an honor and privilege to say a few words to the class this evening. I have two thoughts I want to share with you. These are great life learnings. First is the mindset of living each moment and being kind to yourself daily. Life unfolds in the present, but oftentimes we let the present slip away, allowing time to rush past unobserved and squandering the precious seconds of our lives as we worry about the future and ruminate about what has passed. I recently came across a quotation that reminds us how precious time really is. It states, "Time is like a river. You cannot touch the same water twice because that flow that has passed will never pass again." We humans get quite creative about in the present moment. We sometimes wish to be anywhere, anytime, except for here and now. We habitually filter our experience through thick overlays of worries, memories, hopes, and our own internal conversations. Consequently, at the end of the day, we often wonder where the day went. Then we do it all over again, Monday to Friday. In the words of Eckhart Tolle, a self-help author, most humans are never fully present in the now because, unconsciously, they believe that the next moment must be more important than this one. But then, you miss your whole life, which is never now. And that is a revelation for some people to realize that your life is always only ever now. We have to remember that we are not our thoughts and that mindfulness or living for the moment involves being with your thoughts as they are, neither grasping at them nor pushing them away. Instead of letting your life go by without living it, you awaken to experience life. Live each moment at a time and appreciate the beauty of what unfolds around you. So grads, slow down, live each moment as you embark on your next life adventures. The second reflection is centered on the importance of living your values and never being silent about the hard things you will encounter in the arena of life. Your values simply can be defined as a way of being or believing what you hold most important every day. You will know you're using a values filter when a decision is somewhere between tough and really hard. We all know doing the right things is never easy, as almost all the time it takes up guts, courage, and vulnerability to stand up for all of the injustices, behaviors, and language around us that is dehumanizing. Having a strong sense of your values and being clear in your head and heart about what you stand for will help you speak up and show up regularly for people in pain, no matter who is sitting next to you or in those special seats in the arena of life. So grads, as you continue in the arena of life, you will encounter difficult moments when you know you have to be strong and brave and your fundamental values tested. Yet, as we all know and have experienced, those moments can be overwhelming, and you can easily choose the exit sign in the arena of life that promises immediate relief from the discomfort from the people around you in the stands that engage in dehumanizing behaviors that discriminate because of race, age, gender, class, sexual orientation, physical ability, and cognitive ability, to name just a few. But your head and heart, driven by your values, will know always the right thing to do. To quote Dr. Brené Brown, it's important to remember that there are no guarantees in the arena of life. We will struggle, we will even fail, and we will falter. There'll be times of darkness, but if we are clear about the values that guide us in our efforts to show up for people in pain and be seen, we'll always be able to find the light and joy and live courageously aligned with what we believe is always right. So in closing, congratulations, Sardis Secondary School Class of 2023. We are so proud of all your hard work and your accomplishments. Here's wishing you the very best in life as you continue to show up for people in pain, experience life moment by moment, and thrive every single day. Take good care. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Arul Pragasam, for your words of wisdom and awesome message to the grads. I now invite Terry Westerby, Chilliwack School District Trustee, to present a message to the graduating class. Welcome, Terry.
Ms. Whale, and good evening. My name is Terry Westerby. My pronouns are he and him, and I'm a Chilliwack School Board Trustee. A little taller. On behalf of the Chilliwack School Board, we would like to express our heartfelt congratulations to all the parents, guardians, caregivers and families, educators, and Principal Lynette Schramm for your dedication to these students and to this school. I know that I, for one, am incredibly impressed at how hard all of you work and how dedicated you are to education and to these students. To the graduates of the Sardis Secondary School 2023, you did it! Yeah! Yes! You did it. Today represents a significant milestone in your academic journey, one that you should be immensely proud of. You have not just accomplished a great academic feat, but you have also shown resilience and tenacity in the face of incredible challenges. You have overcome many obstacles to get to this point, and your hard work has paid off in a big way. I'm honored to be able to share in this special moment with all of you. All of you. I know exactly the mix of feelings that accompany this significant milestone in your life. Like Chief Epp said, it wasn't that long ago for me either. It's both exhilarating and terrifying. I can feel it. I can feel it in this room tonight. What I can assure you of is that your family, your friends, and the entire school faculty and administration are indeed filled with immense joy and pride for this occasion. I want you to take a moment and look around the room. Look to your left and your right. I can see you. I want to see you looking. Make eye contact with the people beside you. Think about all the people who are in this space, sharing in this moment with you. Sharing in your achievements. Your classmates, your teachers, your family. You have all forged so many meaningful relationships with each other throughout your academic journey. Remember the moments of laughter, the times of joy, and challenges, and how you helped each other overcome them. This is your community. This is your resilience. You are part of something bigger than yourself. A community of individuals who have invested their time and their energy and their resources into helping you get to this point. Your coaches, your teachers, your peers, parents and family and mentors have all played an integral role in your journey, supporting, encouraging, and guiding you to reach your full potential. They have pushed you to be the best version of yourself, and it's important to recognize that you could not have gotten here without them. Sometimes we forget that it's the people we surround ourselves with that shape who we are and help us on our journey to success. You are now a part of a greater community. Your classmates and these relationships will be a solid foundation for you and your future endeavors. As you move on to explore the vast opportunities ahead, I challenge you to stay connected, engaged, and active in your community. And seek out ways to get involved in mentoring, volunteering, and making a difference in the world through relationships and connection. These relationships will not only enrich your life, but they will also help you find the resources and opportunities that you need for success. As the saying goes, together we can achieve more. Now you can use this occasion as a starting off point, a fresh chapter to pursue your dreams. Take inspiration from your achievements today. Do not let this moment pass you by. See it as a launching pad. Use your success to make the positive impact in the world. You have a power to affect change and inspire others. I believe that each and every one of you has what it takes to achieve greatness, and I look forward to seeing the incredible things that you do in the future. So congratulations again, grads.
Thank you, Trustee Westerby, for your inspiring and insightful message. It is now my distinct privilege to invite Lynette Schramm, principal of Sardis Secondary, to present her message to the 2023 Sardis graduating class.
Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, trustees, honorable guests, members of the faculty, proud parents and guardians, and above all, Sardis Secondary's graduating class of 2023. It is an honor and a privilege to be here tonight speaking on behalf of the staff of Sardis Secondary. As an administrator, it's a perk of the job to be able to spend some time in classrooms from time to time. Amongst many opportunities this year, I was able to spend some time with a Philosophy 12 class. I honestly can't quite remember the task they were working on that day, but I remember a conversation I had with a few students. They were telling me what they wanted to do after graduation, their goals for the careers that lay ahead. One student mentioned that they would like to be as rich as Elon Musk, which led us to Google, where Elon Musk is from, and how did he get to be so rich? I was brought back to that memory recently when I was watching the news on the unsuccessful flight of Musk's SpaceX Starship. Now, I want to be honest with you. I'm not an Elon Musk fan for various reasons, and I don't want to be the world's richest person. I'm blessed where I am with what I have. However, there are some things that can be learned about him and from his life choices, thoughts that I want to highlight with you this evening to challenge you as you graduate and pursue your own goals. The first, it doesn't matter where you start from or that your path may not be straight. When we Googled to find out where Musk became so rich, we found that he was born in South Africa. His parents divorced when he was 8. When he was 18, he went to University of South Africa for just 5 months before coming to Canada. Did you know he came to Canada? Once here, he lived in Saskatchewan, where he worked on a farm with his second cousin. And then he came out to Vancouver to work at a mill before attending Queen's University for 2 years. After transferring to the University of Pennsylvania to earn his bachelor's degree in economics and physics, he then moved to California to attend Stanford. He dropped out after 2 days. His plan was to get a job with Netscape. He never received a callback. He then went on to co-found different software companies, including Confinity, that is now known as PayPal, and SpaceX, selling some companies once they became successful for millions or even billions. Amongst other things he did with his money, he invested in Tesla, becoming the majority shareholder. And the rest, you could probably Google him. But I think you get my point. Grads, where did your journey begin? And where has it taken you so far? Maybe it started in Chilliwack with you picking raspberries as your summer job or living on a farm. Or maybe your parents are divorced or you're living on your own. No matter your path or your journey so far, you are here. You are graduating. You have reached this milestone, and it's only onwards and upwards from here. Will it be straight as you pursue your next goals, or will it take different directions as you navigate your life? Both types of paths are okay. No matter your story so far, my second point, what's important is where you're heading and that you never give up. When Musk sold PayPal for $1.5 billion in 2002, he could have stopped. He could have retired. I don't know about you, but I'd be happy if I just won one Lotto Max Millions. But he didn't stop. He pressed on. I don't know his reasons. I don't think that's the lesson. The lesson is that you shouldn't settle. Always strive to be bigger and better and to keep pushing the envelope and seeing just how far you can reach and the impact you can make. And don't think it matters if you aren't the brightest student or you struggle in writing persuasive essays or you can't draw to save your life. Leaving a high-flying job in management consulting at the age of 27, Angela Lee Duckworth took a job teaching math to seventh graders in a New York public school. She then went on to get a degree in psychology in order to research what separates the successful students from those who struggle. And you know what she found? It wasn't social intelligence, good looks, physical health, or even IQ. It was grit. Having passion and perseverance for your long-term goals, sticking with your future day in and day out, working really hard to making that future a reality, living life as if it was a marathon, not a sprint. I think Pat Summitt, legendary coach of the University of Tennessee's Lady Vols basketball team, said it best. Winning is a good feeling, but it passes, and what lasts is what you have learned. Winning is not the point. Wanting to win is the point. Not giving up is the point. Never letting up is the point. Never being satisfied with what you have done is the point. If you didn't watch the news that night in April, or you just weren't interested in the story, after separation, 8 minutes into liftoff, Musk's SpaceX Starship's mission was to make a partial lap around the Earth coming down in the Pacific Ocean near Hawaii about 90 minutes after launch. The ultimate goal of Starship is to eventually evolve into a fully reusable launch and landing system designed to take perhaps 100 astronauts at a time for trips to the Moon, Mars, and other destinations. But that day in April, at first glance, the goals of the mission that day were not met. In fact, the spaceship exploded 4 minutes and 3 seconds into its flight. A far cry from 90 minutes. In my eyes, that flight was a total bust. Which then caused me to question when the newscaster said that it was an exciting end to the test flight. Like, what? Did you not just see what happened? It exploded. It didn't do anything it was supposed to do. And then the newscast showed SpaceX Mission Control at the time of the explosion. And to my utter amazement, there was loud, ongoing cheering from the people in the small control room and from all the people crammed into the lobby. And again, I sat there in wonder, what the heck is happening? Then Chris Hadfield, retired Canadian astronaut, explained, the whole reason for the test is to find out what goes wrong and to let things fail. He said, you can pretend as long as you want, but eventually you gotta go actually launch this thing. And they were so successful today. Another newscaster added, the goal for today was just to get the massive thing off the launch pad. SpaceX has explosions. They end in fireballs, and every time that happens, SpaceX learns from that. They are very good at learning from their failures. They will characterize today as a successful failure. And in fact, they didn't even call it a failure. They didn't call it an explosion. They called it a rapid, unscheduled disassembly. And therein lie my next 2 points. Point three, only you know your goals. Only you can define what is a success or a failure. What may be a failure in someone else's eyes may be exactly what is necessary on your journey to becoming the person you are meant to be. With a growth mindset, know that failure isn't a permanent condition. Stay true to who you are. Keep focused on your goals and don't take failure as ultimate. Make it a stepping stone. You know the difference between a master and a beginner? The master has failed more times than the beginner has even tried. Be willing to fail, to be wrong, to start over again with lessons learned. But my last point was what resonated with me the longest after watching the rapid, unscheduled disassembly. The SpaceX family cheered. They didn't get dejected. They didn't turn and blame the other person next to them for their failure or mix-up. They didn't make fun of, ridicule, or point out the flaws. They knew the story. They knew the goals. They knew that this was an improvement from the last attempted launch where the spaceship exploded on the launch pad. And so it is with you. You have people in your lives, your people, and as my family calls it, your community. Be they family, friends, mentors, teachers, coaches, pastors, you have your people. Those that know you best and know your story. Listen to their cheers. Feel their support today and as you move forward in life. Know that they will be cheering for you on your journey no matter what it looks like. And when you can't hear them so loudly, I'm supplying you with a reminder. You're being given a small memento in your grad portfolio this evening. It looks like this. It's a little green ribbon and it simply says, who I am makes a difference. To wat al eltha shwala shtuk, which in Helkamalam means who I am matters. This ribbon can be left in your folder or hung on your mirror or folded up and put in your wallet to remind yourself daily of how proud we are of you and how much of an impact you have made on us while here. But I wanted to go beyond that and challenge you. You can keep that ribbon to yourself. You have earned it. It is true of you. Who you are makes a difference daily. However, you can also choose to use it to acknowledge the difference someone else had made in your life. A mentor, a parent, coach, teacher. Or if there is someone you want to inspire, someone coming behind you, maybe someone you've tutored, coached, mentored, been a link leader of, maybe even your younger sibling, someone that you want to encourage to do their best, to embrace their challenges set before them, to push on despite failures, and to listen to their people, you, who will be cheering them on to bigger successes. I'll leave that decision to you. So grads of 2023, you've been on this road called high school for the last 4 years. Eyes to the horizon, straining to see the end of this current marathon. You are almost there. 5 more get-ups. I want to encourage each one of you, as you leave Sardis and venture out into your next chapters, as you are successful, and you will be successful, go out into the world and influence it, change it, make it better, but above all, be significant. Make your life matter. Don't worry if your path isn't straight. Never give up. Define your own success and rely and listen to the support of your people. And then come back every so often and share with us your journeys, because no matter where you go or what you do in life, Sardis will always be your home. You will always be a member of our family. Some of your people will be there cheering you on always, because once a Falcon,
always a Falcon.
Awesome.
Thank you, Ms. Schramm, for your insightful words. I now invite Maddie Kennedy and Ryan Shea, members of the graduating class, to present their tribute to our parents, your parents. Give them a welcome to the stage.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Hello, everybody. My name is Ryan.
And my name is Maddie.
We have been honored with the opportunity to speak in front and before our wonderful student body, faculty, guests, and families on this wonderful night called Commencement. Today, we will recognize and direct our speech towards one specific group of people.
The people we are honoring are the backbone and foundation of the students that sit here today. The people who made us who we are, who taught us about compassion and love, who taught us our please and thank yous, and who taught us what a good role model looks like in life.
They're the MVP, the sixth man of the year, coach of the year, assistant of the year, and trainer of the year. They are
our parents.
Not only the parents, but whoever along the way that made it possible for you to be here in the position you are today. From grandparents to aunts and uncles, siblings, cousins, and friends, we are honoring you and thanking you.
Graduation is not just a huge moment in our lives, it is for you as parents as well. We are not simply leaving school and moving on to the next thing. We are one step closer to growing up and leaving home. It seems impossible to thank all the parents and guardians for their immeasurable impact on our lives, but we will give it our best shot, because if there's one thing our parents have taught us, it is that nothing is impossible if you have a kind heart, determination, and parents who will show up to a 3-hour service to watch you walk across the stage and take a million photos, because they could not be any happier to see you succeed in life.
From the day we were born, you were always there for us. As 8-pound little nuggets of joy or terror, you loved us. You would read books on how to parent, paint our rooms before we could walk in them, and doubt your abilities as a parent every time we cried, not knowing you were already the greatest parents life could give us, just because you loved us.
Since the day I started walking, my parents have called me their sunshine. This is something that I hold close to my heart, because no one else in my life has made me so important that they tell me how their world literally revolves around me. And even on the cloudiest of days, they gave me a place to shine. I believe that every graduate sitting here is a sun for someone's world, whether that be their parents, guardians, grandparents, or others.
I feel this stage in our life, where we started crawling and walking, transitioning from a stationary crying object to a moving one, is where we learn the most. We learn about ourselves, the world, and the people that surround us. And it's you, the parents, that are our first role models. The people we inevitably shape into being, teaching us the ways of the world and life itself, and we salute you for that.
As our lives progress, we start in school and begin to develop a beginning of independence. But as we all know, the parents are never too far behind and always end up giving a helping hand, albeit homework, packing, our lunch, or driving us to a sleepover. It's amazing. The job of a parent taxi is never over. From one sport to the next, or one recital to another, even in times they do not want to do it, they find a way and some motivation to get us where we need to be.
They're there for us through puberty, tough times, friend drama, and injuries. Our parents really can do it all. Except teach some of us how to drive, because we always end up needing like a driving instructor. I don't know, just saying. But nonetheless, the guts that our parents have to get into a car with us right after getting our learners is unparalleled in this universe. It truly demonstrates the trust and confidence they have in us, and it was instilled from the beginning. All that time our parents put into helping us learn to drive pays off when we finally obtain the N. This is a huge step in our lives for independence due to no more parent taxi being needed. A bittersweet feeling I'm sure all parents felt. And this is about the time where everyone is deciding how they want to spend their next couple of years out of high school. Some of our choices may have been heavily influenced by our upbringings, while others might have chosen a different path. Whatever it may be, our parents have guided us, and we will forever be in your gratitude for providing us with a multitude of different experiences to live through and to lead us into our days after high school.
We want to thank you for the huge part that you have played in our success, as we all know that we would not be the people we are today without you. So we would like to thank the parents who showed up to sports games, the parents who carried us into the house after we fell asleep in the car, the parents who raised us by themselves, the parents who faced the greatest challenges in their lives and still put a smile on our faces, and to the parents who believed in us. We would not be here without you. We want you to know that we recognize the strength, love, and humility that you carried throughout our lives. We want you to know that we are proud of who we are because we have you to look up to, and we promise to use the support and guidance that you have given us to do nothing but good in the world.
We love you.
And at this time, we would like to invite our parents, mine and Ryan's, up to the front because we have a flower bouquet for you guys to just show a little bit of our gratitude towards you guys.
Oh my, thank you, Maddie and Ryan, for those absolutely beautiful words. I think I'm tearing up a little bit, actually. It is at this point in our program that we are very proud and delighted to introduce you to each graduate as they receive a Class of 2023 certificate. Once students have successfully completed their required courses, each will receive a graduate certificate from the province of British Columbia. With the support of the Chilliwack community, these students will be embarking on new journeys that will bring new challenges and opportunities. On Tuesday, June 6th, many of these students received scholarships and bursaries. A total of $700,595 was received by this year's graduating class.
That's almost a million.
That's a lot.
Tonight, we will also be recognizing students with outstanding academic achievement and the highest standards of academic integrity. Exemplary scholars will be wearing a green honor cord. These are students who have been recognized as exemplary, scholars in grades 10, 11, and 12. Additionally, we'll be recognizing distinguished academic achievement as of commencement. The top 5% of the graduating class will have a gold cord, indicating the distinction of summa cum laude. The top 10% will have a silver cord, representing magna cum laude, and the top 15% have achieved cum laude, symbolized by a bronze cord.
Now, at this time, I would like to invite up to the platform Lynette Schramm, principal of Sardis Secondary School, along with the school vice principals, beginning with Jeff Dartnell. Rohan Arul Pragasm, superintendent of the Chilliwack School District, and our staff presenters. During the course of the presentation, formal photographs of the graduates will be projected on the screen. Please hold your applause until each teacher has read all of the names in each group of approximately 30 graduates. Professional photos are being taken of each graduate as they descend from the stage. You will be given a complimentary copy of this photo at the end of June. Please join me in thanking Mr. Kevin Beagle and Mr. Chris Warner for providing the background accompaniment this evening as we present the graduates. And now I would like to invite Allison Guy to the podium to begin introducing the graduating class of 2023.
Good evening. Ready? Caitlin Adams. Caitlin is graduating magna cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Caitlin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley and then transfer to UBC. Her goal is to pursue a career in genetic counseling. Sierra Adamson. Sierra is very thankful to everyone she has met and who has supported her in the past 4 years. Shaden Affleck. Shaden plans to become a kinesiologist and have a happy and successful life. Star Ajabu. Star plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley, the Northern British Columbia, to become a paleontologist. Zachary Alderson. Zachary plans to attend university. His goal is to have a happy life. Marley Allenson. Marley plans to attend Camosun College and finish at the University of Victoria, pursuing a career in nursing. Her goal is to make a positive impact on our healthcare system. Ashley Allen. Ashley is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Ashley plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in chemical and biological engineering. She would like to thank the many teachers who helped support her throughout her time at Sardis Secondary. She would also like to say a huge thank you to her parents for the love and support and for shaping who she is today. Eliza Gwen Alotinto. Eliza plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to achieve her dream and be successful. Foster Anderson. Foster plans to attend university. His goal is to have a successful career. Lily Angus Pinner. Lily plans to attend post-secondary to earn her BA in anthropology. Caleb Anthorn. Caleb plans to make money and dream big. His goal is to make the best out of his life. Colby Anstenson. Colby plans to get a culinary certificate and travel the world while working as a chef before becoming an air traffic controller. Jenna Archakin. Jenna plans to attend university to pursue a career in biological sciences. Brody Archibald. Brody plans to work and save money. His goal is to become a firefighter. Rachel Arnold. Rachel is graduating magna cum laude. Rachel plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a degree and hopefully a career in theater. Lyndon Arnish. Lyndon plans to continue on to post-secondary education and pursue a career in mechanics. Isabel Barda. Isabel plans to continue to post-secondary education to pursue a career in law at the University of Toronto. Xavier Ball. Xavier is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Xavier plans to attend the university to pursue a career in commerce. His goal is to double major in finance and entrepreneurship. He endeavors to own and operate his own business one day. Kimiko Barr. Kimiko plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to earn a Bachelor of Arts in Sociology. Her goal is to get a master's in speech and language and become a speech pathologist. Gavnor Bhatt. Gavnor plans to attend the entry-level trades program at an electrical joint training facility to pursue a career as an electrician. Jet Baxter. Jet plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to study neurology and psychology. His goal is to study abroad at Leiden University. Nicole Bell. Nicole plans to attend university to pursue a career in elementary education. Simon Berg. Simon is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Simon plans to pursue a career in mathematics and be successful. Rowan Bergen. Rowan plans to be an artist and to have a happy life. Isaac Bill. Isaac plans to attend university and study in the science and math field. His goal is to be rich. Alexis Berner, McGann. Alexis plans to take a gap year. Her goal is to attend university and study criminology. Brighton Bitts. Brighton plans to study abroad in Spain. Her goal is to teach English in other countries. Jessica Blanchard. Jessica plans to finish her culinary degree and then attend UBC for her English literary degree. Her goal is to one day become an English teacher. JJ Blessin. JJ is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. JJ plans to attend the University of British Columbia to study chemical engineering. His goal is to make positive changes in the world by combining his love of science with his passion for life. Jake Bloxham. Jake plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in computers. Marissa Bobbitt. Marissa plans to attend University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in criminology or interior design. Kyle Bonato. Kyle plans to work for a year. His goal is to become a firefighter. Joey Boucher. Joey plans to attend university to study English and education. His goal is to become a creative writing teacher and work at Sardis Secondary. Taylor Bowden. Taylor is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Taylor plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a career in French immersion teaching. She would like to say how proud she is of the class of 23 for persevering through the challenges of the last 4 years. Joshua Bowles. Joshua plans to achieve a career in computer science. His goal is to bring entertainment to people and improve the lives of others. It is now my pleasure to introduce Paula Black to present the next group of graduates. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. It is my pleasure to introduce the next set of graduates. We're all so very proud of them. Jaden Brent. Jaden plans to have a happy and successful life. Kaylee Bricks. Kaylee is graduating cum laude. Kaylee plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in forensic psychology. Tyler Bryce. Tyler plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to become a welder. Ethan Buchanan. Ethan is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Ethan plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in the sciences. Kieran Campbell. Kieran plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in engineering. Valen Campbell. Valen plans to pursue a career in landscaping and to have a successful life. Alex Carneal. Alex plans to travel and explore what the world offers them and what they can offer it, and to continue building a life that makes them happy. Thomas Caruso. Thomas plans to attend SFU to further his athletic and academic interests. His goal is to become an asset to the SFU varsity swim team and eventually pursue a career in law enforcement. Davina Cater. Davina is graduating cum laude. Davina plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue her Bachelor of Business and have a successful career in marketing. Alexis Chapman. Alexis plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in social work. Austin Charlton. Austin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as an electrician. Their goal is to start their own company and live a long and happy life. Nicholas Covenants. Nicholas plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in mechanical engineering. Leo Clark. Leo plans to take a gap year to pursue full-time work and travel. Their goal is to attend UVic to pursue a degree in psychology. Nikia Clark. Nikia plans to attend Kwantlen Polytechnic University for product design. Carmen Cox. Carmen plans to work for a year and then return to school. Her goal is to become a dental assistant. Chloe Dates. Chloe plans to attend the university and to study to become a midwife. Carson Dahl. Carson plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley and then transfer to UVic to become an engineer. Mats Daniluz. Mats plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a degree in economics. Cole Davis. Cole plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley for the Bachelor of Computer Information System courses. Cole says, "Thank you to my family for helping me, especially my mom, for all you have done." Zach DeCaney. Zach plans to work for a year or two and figure out what he wants to do. His goal is to find a job he loves. Sierra Denego. Sierra plans to work at Stolo Nation and help the environment. Her goal is to live in Vancouver. Haley Dibski. Haley is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Haley plans to take a gap year to travel and to do volunteer work abroad. Samuel Dong. Samuel is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Samuel plans to attend the University of British Columbia to become a general practitioner to help people. Shayla Duell. Shayla is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Shayla plans to travel and volunteer abroad. She is considering a career in marine biology. Tyrus Doucette. Tyrus plans to take a year off to save some money before going back to school to study business. His goal is to own his own business someday. Tegan Downer. Tegan is graduating cum laude. Tegan plans to attend the University of Calgary to pursue a career in biology. Blake Doyle. Blake plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a career in medicine. Kayla Drew. Kayla is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Kayla plans to attend McGill University to pursue a Bachelor of Science in Kinesiology with the goal of later pursuing a career in medicine. She also will continue training on the BC team to attend the Canada Summer Games in 2025 for artistic swimming. Summer Duick. Summer is planning to go to the University of the Fraser Valley to become a licensed practical nurse. Leah Duff. Leah plans to go to school to build robots. She would like to thank her family for supporting her. Zoe Duff. Zoe plans to go to veterinarian school to become a vet. She would like to thank her mom, dad, and grandparents. And I would now like to introduce Mrs. Jen Wheeler to present the next group of graduates.
Good evening. Darren Duncalf. Darren plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to study computer science. His goal is to become a programmer. Tanner Dunn. Tanner plans to attend the British Columbia Institute of Technology to become a power engineer. Tan Duong. Tan plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley. The goal is to grow to become a better person than he was yesterday. Declan Eastham. Declan plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in nursing. Cole Edkins. Cole plans to continue in the trades. His goal is to become an electrician. Jaden Edwards. Jaden plans to participate in an apprenticeship program to pursue a career in the trades. Jenna Evans. Jenna plans to take a year off. Her goal is to further her education and have fun while doing so. Janelle Ewert. Janelle is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. Janelle plans to attend Torchbearers Bible School in France. Her goal is to gain new life experiences and find the career she is passionate about. Logan Fast. Logan plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to further his education. His goal is to live a fulfilling life. Andrew Fawcett. Andrew is graduating cum laude. Andrew plans to attend university. His goal is to graduate with a degree in civil engineering. Autumn Fayant. Autumn plans to work for 2 years and then attend college. Their goal is to become a massage therapist. Bella Ferrero. Bella plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to do the mechanics program. Nolan Flannery. Nolan plans to attend university to pursue a degree in business. Edie Foreman. Edie plans to attend Simon Fraser University to study kinesiology. Her goal is to pursue a career in sports medicine. Amy Friesen. Amy plans to spend a year traveling and then attend university to pursue a career in zoology. Mackenzie Gadden. Mackenzie plans to attend UBCO to pursue a career in criminal law. Their goal is to achieve a bachelor's in criminology and hopefully achieve a bachelor's in literature. Haley Gagnon. Haley is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. Haley plans to continue on to university to study engineering. Peyton Galley. Peyton plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in marketing. Kira Gansky. Kira plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as a welder. Jeremiah Gibbs. Jeremiah plans to pursue a career in business and to have a successful life. Caitlin Gophers. Caitlin is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. Caitlin plans to attend the University of Toronto. Her goal is to pursue a career in medicine to become a pediatric surgeon. She would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her throughout her academic journey. Amaya Gonzalez-Darris. Amaya plans to explore her interests. Her goal is to figure out her dream career. Levi Goodwin. Levi plans to continue his trades education at the University of the Fraser Valley to become a Red Seal welder and fabricator. Jaleesa Hackner. Jaleesa plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a law degree. Her goal is to become a lawyer. Isaac Gordon. Isaac plans to attend the Schulich School of Engineering to become a geological engineer. Jack Gordon. Jack plans to further their education at university. Their goal is to be rich and successful. Regan Grattan. Regan is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Regan plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in chemistry. His goal is to earn a Bachelor's of Science degree majoring in chemistry. Sarah Gray. Sarah plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to complete the Bachelor of Arts program. Tegan Green. Tegan plans to attend a post-secondary school. She would like to thank her family and friends for everything they have done for her. Caleb Greer Evans plans to get his real estate license and become a real estate agent. Jasmine Graywall. Jasmine plans to attend university to pursue a career in graphic design. Michael Graywall. Michael plans to pursue his passion of promoting inclusion and diversity in our community. Cami Gudjonsson. Cami is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Cami plans to attend UBCO to pursue a career in science. Her goal is to become a research scientist. Jacob Goretzky. Jacob plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in accounting. Jessica Goretzky. Jessica plans to attend Bible school in France in September for 8 months. Her goal is to work in the healthcare system. I would now like to introduce Bev Hagerman to present the next group of graduates.
Thank you. Kennedy Haglin. Kennedy plans to study psychology and become a forensic psychologist. Nick Hagerman plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley in the trades program. His goal is to get his Red Seal certification as a construction electrician. McKenna Hallett. McKenna plans to have a successful life. She would like to thank her parents and Kaylee for keeping her going. Dayton Hamilton. Dayton plans to join the military. His goal is to learn skills in the military to eventually join law enforcement. Sarah Hamilton. Sarah plans to attend the University of British Columbia to study professional and creative writing. Her goal is to achieve a Bachelor of Arts. Mason Hanks. Mason is graduating cum laude. Mason plans to attend the University of Calgary with the goal to work as an occupational therapist. Justin Hari. Justin is graduating cum laude. Justin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to complete a BBA. His goal is to become a consumer's consultant. Madison Harnett. Madison plans to take some time to discover her passion. Her goal is to find a career she loves. Dennis Haas. Dennis plans to open a cafe with a friend. His goal is to become a kinder and gentler person. Matthew Higgs. Matthew wants to win the lottery so he can afford to buy a house and travel the world. Cassidy Hewitt. Cassidy is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholarship. Kennedy plans to attend Thompson Rivers University to pursue a career in the sciences. McKenna Hislop. McKenna plans to take a year off and travel. The goal is to become a medical lab assistant. Hannah Horton. Hannah plans to study the culinary arts. Her goal is to own her own bakery one day. Carter Horvath. Carter plans to go to the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in electrical engineering. Darren Humchit. Darren plans to take welding classes and forge a life for himself. Trinity Ibrahim. Trinity plans to pursue hairdressing and earn her Red Seal certification. Julia James. Julia plans to study psychology in the university in the future. Her goal is to become a psychologist. Clara Johnson. Clara is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Clara plans to attend the University of Victoria. Her goal is to work in artificial intelligence and make her family proud. Jessica Johnson. Jessica is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Jessica plans to attend the university to pursue a degree in the sciences. Joey Johnson. Joey plans to travel the world and hike the Pacific Crest Trail. Viola Kanzler. Viola plans to study business and psychology. The goal is to own their own business and travel through Europe. Levi Karaman. Levi plans to pursue a career in welding and earn his Red Seal. His goal is to contribute on to be a paramedic or first responder. Maddie Kennedy. Maddie is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Maddie would like to thank her friends and family for always motivating and supporting her. She would also like to give special thank you to her grandma Tracy, for she wouldn't be the person she is today without her. Aaron Kim. Aaron plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a career as a writer. Caitlin Kinchek. Caitlin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley and travel the world. Eli King Scobie. Eli plans to take a gap year to finalize his post-secondary plans. His goal is to pursue a career in corporate law. Amelie Klammer. Amelie is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. Amelie plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in international relations and diplomacy, as well as teach English and French abroad. Marissa Clausen. Marissa is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Marissa plans to attend university to study psychology and social sciences. Her goal is to become a lawyer. Sophia Clausen. Sophia is graduating summa cum laude and exemplary scholar. Sophia plans to study environmental engineering at the University of British Columbia. Kaylin Conrad. Kaylin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley for heavy duty mechanics. His goal is to be Red Seal certified. Alexis Crayonville. Alexis plans to have a happy life and be successful. Jackson Cron. Jackson plans to be a heavy-duty mechanic and make big bucks. His goal is to work hard and love life. Kira Langer. Kira plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to complete a Bachelor of Science in Nursing. I would like to introduce Kevin Siggity to present the next group of graduates.
There we go. It is my pleasure to introduce the following graduates. Elijah Levine. Elijah plans to attend the British Columbia Institute of Technology to pursue a career in software development. Skylar Leland. Skylar plans to take a gap year before attending the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in biology. So we're going to read Skylar again. Skylar Leland. Skylar plans to take a gap year before attending the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in biology. Lucas LaViolette. Lucas plans to attend the British Columbia Institute of Technology to pursue a career in software development. Nathaniel LaRue. Nathaniel plans to attend William Jewell College in Kansas City, Missouri, USA on a lacrosse scholarship. His goal is to help make positive change in our community by being a part of building a low-income housing to lessen the struggle on families, seniors, and young adults. Paige Latham. Paige is graduating magna cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Paige plans to attend a carpentry in Europe. Her goal is to open a bookstore one day. Zhisheng Li. Zhisheng plans to continue their schooling and travel. Their goal is to learn new things. Shaylin Lytle. Shaylin is graduating cum laude. Shaylin plans to attend Camosun College to pursue a career in athletic therapy. Adeline Liddley. Adeline plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in psychology. Her goal is to achieve a master's in psychology and a bachelor of arts. Keaton Lilly. Keaton plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in business. The goal is to become a successful business owner. Aristotle Linders. Aristotle plans to attend art school in Nova Scotia to pursue a career in art. His goal is to become an art teacher and to pass on the joy of learning about art. Hannah Litchfield. Hannah plans to attend JIBC to pursue a career as a paramedic. Roy Liu. Roy is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Roy plans to attend the University of Toronto to pursue a career in computer science. Daphne Loebs. Daphne plans to work at a job he likes and have a successful life. Samantha Lopecki plans to go to Camosun College, plans to go to the Vancouver College of Massage Therapy to become a registered massage therapist. Beatrice Longhurst. Beatrice is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Bea plans to attend the University of British Columbia. She wants to thank her family for their love and support. Dasmin Lush. Dasmin plans to attend the Blanche McDonald to become a professional hairstylist. Marilyn McCleary. Mary plans to attend university close to family. Her goal is to become the teacher that students hope for and deserve. Frances McDonald. Frances is graduating magna cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Frances plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley, then transferring to UBC to pursue a career in the Air Force. Shane McFarlane. Shane plans to attend the University of Northern British Columbia to pursue a career in IT. Cole McNeil. Cole plans to take a year off. The goal is to work at Syndicant Welding. Louise Falco. Louise plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in graphic design and digital. Jordan Marsden. Jordan plans to pursue a career with CN Railway. His goal is to retire to Mexico at the age of 40. Ella Marsden. Ella plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as a teacher. Martin Martinez Peters. Martin plans to take his business degree and pursue basketball. His goal is to be the best vision of himself through the best of worst times and the worst of best times. Naomi Martinez. Naomi plans to attend Douglas College to complete the veterinarian technician course. Darian Mayer. Darian plans to pursue a career in border security to help protect the country. Asia Marzaru. Asia plans to earn a Bachelor of Arts in Criminology at UFE. Her goal is to become a forensic scientist. Madison McGee. Madison plans to take a year and work. The goal is to pursue a career in photography. Garrett McGuire. Garrett is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Garrett plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in engineering. Hunter McInnes. Hunter plans to play hockey and attend college. His goal is to play the highest level of hockey that he can reach. Emily McInroy. Emily plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley for a bachelor's degree in psychology. Her goal is to pursue a career in corrections or therapy. Emily would like to thank her family and friends for supporting her. Mason McKenzie. Mason plans to attend the Arizona State University to pursue a career in sports broadcasting. His goal is to get a lot of dough. Isaiah McMahon. Isaiah is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Isaiah plans to pursue a business degree at university while playing varsity soccer. Brooklyn McMullen. Brooklyn plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in psychology. Her goal is to become a child therapist and continue to teach her love of dance all throughout university. Emma McParlett. Emma plans to attend the University, the British Columbia Institute of Technology to pursue a career in business. I would now like to introduce Marianne Beveridge to present the next group of graduates.
Hey, Swale. It's an honor to present the next group of graduates. Peyton McPherson. Peyton plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as a therapist. Miles Merchant Long. Miles plans to open a window and door service business. His goal is to be able to live the life of which he dreams. Brady Merritt. Brady plans to further his education while continuing to pursue his passion for baseball. Annetta Metella. Annetta is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Annetta plans to attend the University of British Columbia Okanagan campus to pursue a career in nursing. Indigo Meikle. Indigo plans to become a collision repair technician. Her goal is to eventually open her own shop. Aiden Miller. Aiden plans to continue his learning in the UFV welding program. His goal is to become a certified welder and work in metal fabrication. Cole Miller. Cole is graduating cum laude. Cole plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to continue his education while pursuing a career in hockey. Easton Mills. Easton plans to attend the heavy machinery operating course. His goal is to be successful in life. Darian Moberly. Darian plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue kinesiology. His goal is to become a medical sports medicine physician. Anaya Moore. Anaya plans to attend the University of Alberta to pursue a Bachelor of Science in the nursing program. Ella Mordaunt. Ella is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Ella plans to go to university to pursue a career in kinesiology. Her goal is to become an occupational therapist. Jordan Morris. Jordan plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in criminology. Sophia Moss. Sophia is graduating cum laude. Sophia plans to go to the University of the Fraser Valley to continue her education. Brandon Muse. Brandon plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue general studies. Nicholas Murphy. Nicholas plans to attend university for business degree, and he plans to own his own business. Liam Murren. Liam plans to move to Montreal and study abroad to pursue a career in fashion or philosophy. Cole Muth. Cole plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a career in biology and health information sciences. Asha Lee Mighton. Asha Lee plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley. Her goal is to be a counseling psychologist. Lainey Nehring. Lainey plans to attend post-secondary at the University of the Fraser Valley. Her goal is to graduate and travel the world. Cameron Nelms. Cameron plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a business degree. His goal is to use the business degree to build a business. Brandon Neufeld. Brandon plans to continue his education at the University of the Fraser Valley in the trades program. His goal is to work hard at his plumbing apprenticeship, employment and education, travel, and enjoy the next adventure in life. Keegan Newlove. Keegan plans to pursue his goals in welding and fabrication, as he also graduated from the University of the Fraser Valley Welding Foundations this June. His goal is to acquire a high-paying job in his field and spend more time with his family. Coda Newman. Coda plans to have a very happy and successful life. Emily Nguyen. Emily plans to go to Simon Fraser University to study to become a finance director. Katie Nevikowski. Katie plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in nursing. Her goal is to become a pediatric nurse. Jenna O'Byrne. Jenna plans to take a gap year and then apply to art school. The goal is to have a career in the arts. Aiden O'Rourke. Aiden plans to start an apprenticeship as a millwright and earn his Red Seal. Brenna O'Sell. Brenna is graduating cum laude and exemplary scholar. Brenna plans to attend the University of Calgary to pursue a Bachelor of Arts in English. McKenna Owens. McKenna plans to work for a year before going to university to pursue a career in pediatric nursing. Her goal is to work in a NICU and support families and their newborn babies. Riley Palmer. Riley plans to work for a year His goal is to attend university to pursue business. Tiago Palmer. Tiago is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Tiago plans to pursue a career in biomedical engineering, and his goal is to bring medical sciences into the future. Kevin Damon Papp. Kevin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in electrical. Eva Parada. Eva plans to finish her private pilot's license after graduation. The goal is then to continue on to get her bachelor's degree in fine arts to become an art therapist. Jackson Parr. Jackson plans to attend university to continue his athletic career and study the sciences. I would now like to introduce Mrs. Trish Lewis to present the next group of graduates.
Good evening. The next graduate, Jade Pepin. Jade plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to continue her exploration of art. Aloysius Peter McCarthy. Aloysius plans to pursue a career in the construction industry. Braden Peters. Braden plans to attend the university to study business and kinesiology. Brooklyn Pickford. Brooklyn is graduating cum laude. Brooklyn is pursuing a Bachelor of Science in Kinesiology at the University of Calgary with a goal of practicing sports medicine. Brooklyn will also be representing the University of Calgary on the varsity swim team. Nick Piotta. Nick plans to attend the Royal Military College of Canada to pursue a career in aviation. Claire Pinkney. Claire is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Claire plans to attend UBC and enter their biotechnology program. Her goal is to graduate with a bachelor's degree, work for a few years, and return for graduate studies in genetics. Ansgar Plasante. Ansgar is graduating cum laude. Ansgar plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in chemistry. Christian Plitt. Christian plans on training hard to work with the Coast Guard. Lauren Plummer. Lauren plans to leave in July to au pair in the UK and travel Europe during her gap year. Her goal is to pursue her education at the University of Calgary. Gracie Point. Gracie plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in social work. Tamara Point. Tamara plans to become a police officer after graduating. Her goal is to do the recruiting process for police officers. Carson Pollock. Carson plans to pursue a cooking career and become a successful person. Ava Potier. Ava plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a degree in psychology with honors. She plans to become a youth worker and later get her Master's of Counseling in psychology. Bradley Pracknow. Bradley plans to attend TRU to take heavy-duty mechanics. His goal is to start his own company with a service track. Jordan absent.
Missing Josh Pope.
Joshua Pope. Joshua Pope plans to go to the University of the Fraser Valley to become an electrician.
Ava.
Yes. Ava Potier.
Shoot.
You're okay. Uranus Pranitis. Uranus is graduating magna cum laude, exemplary scholar. Uranus plans to attend the University of Calgary to pursue a career in sports medicine and eventually work for a professional sports team. Chloe Prokopchuk. Chloe is graduating cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Chloe plans to attend university to study business and entrepreneurship. Silas Reimer. Silas plans to attend the University of British Columbia to become a teacher of either math or music and be successful. Darian Rietsma. Darian is graduating cum laude. Darian plans to travel the world. His goal is to get a better insight of other cultures. Dylan Rempel. Dylan plans to study kinesiology and play hockey at UFV. Annabelle Robbins. Annabelle plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to study psychology and then study law at the University of Alberta. She'd like to thank all the people that have supported her along the way. Sophie Roche. Sophie plans to take a gap year to save for university. Their goal is to have a successful career in veterinary medicine. Quinn Rogers. Quinn plans on doing the fire training program to pursue a career as a fireman. Joey Romaine Clausen. Joey plans to continue the heavy-duty mechanic program. His goal is to earn his Red Seal for heavy-duty mechanics. Eric Rommel. Eric plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in business and continue playing competitive hockey. His goal is to become successful in the world of business. Alicia Ryan. Alicia is graduating cum laude. Alicia plans to attend the University of Victoria to pursue a career in psychology. Her goal is to become a mental health therapist. Michaela Brace. Michaela plans to join the Canadian Armed Forces. Her goal is to become an image technician and travel the world. Arlie Roberts. Arlie plans to attend a post-secondary institution. Her goal is to attend Capilano for a motion picture arts diploma. Sakina Sahib. Sakina plans to attend university to pursue a career in custom border services. She would like to thank her parents and family for always supporting her and for their unconditional love. Jenna Salak. Jenna plans to attend Thompson Rivers University this September. Her goal is to study psychology and pursue a career in social work. Amber Sangue. Amber plans to follow her dream of becoming a tattoo artist. She couldn't have done it without the unconditional support from her mother. Francesco Santangelo. Francesco plans to attend the Bocconi University in Milan to pursue a career in economic and social sciences. Thank you to his parents, Daniela and Gianni, for the opportunity to be here. Braden Sawatsky. Braden plans to attend post-secondary to become a Red Seal electrician. And I would now like to introduce Linda Zenzen to present the next group of graduates.
Good evening.
Emily Saar. Emily plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in early childhood education. Elisa Scaccia. Elisa plans to return to her home country, Italy, after concluding this amazing experience in Canada. She wants to thank her parents for making it possible. Amy Schultz. Amy is graduating cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Amy plans to attend the University of British Columbia, Okanagan, for a Bachelor of Applied Science degree. Her goal is to become an engineer. Apollo Scott. Apollo plans to attend university as soon as possible to pursue a degree in computer science. Mason Scott. Mason plans to pursue architecture at the University of the Fraser Valley and BCIT and to become an architect. Marcus Seguin. Marcus plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to complete a bachelor's in kinesiology. Christian Senyuk. Christian is thankful for his parents and their impact on his schooling. Minjae Seo. Minjae is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Minjae plans to earn a Bachelor of Commerce at McGill University. His goal is to work in investment banking and see the top of the wall on Wall Street. Sarah Sharp. Sarah is graduating cum laude. She plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in education. Kaden Shaw. Kaden plans to go to hairdressing school. Their goal is to help others who struggle with managing their hair. Jasper Shea. Jasper is graduating cum laude, an exemplary scholar. He plans to attend the University of Calgary to study engineering. Brian Shea. Brian is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. He plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a degree in forest sciences. Ryder Shea Stako. Ryder plans to pursue a career in heavy-duty mechanics and will be starting his apprenticeship in July. His goal is to complete his Red Seal. Marcus Simpson. Marcus plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to become a welder. River Skinner. River plans to attend the Canadian Flight Academy to become a commercial airline pilot. Malia Sladek. Malia is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Malia plans to attend McGill University to study medicine and become a doctor. Christina Slingerland. Christy is graduating magna cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Christy plans to attend the College of the Rockies to pursue a career in firefighting. Seth Stunenberg. Seth plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to earn a bachelor's degree in political science, then pursue a law degree. Ellie Stevenot. Ellie plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as a mental health technician. Mackenzie Stollings. Mackenzie is graduating cum laude. She plans to attend university to earn a bachelor in business administration. David Sturz. David plans to study engineering at the British Columbia Institute of Technology and become successful. Aya Sugiyama. Aya is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. He plans to pursue a career in nursing. His goal is to help people who are suffering by serving people as a medical professional. Sai Sugiyama. Sai plans to attend university to pursue a degree in the social sciences and have a career with either law, diplomacy, or government work. Connor Sutton. Connor plans to take some time off school and work full-time. Iris Terapaki. Iris plans to attend Kwantlen Polytechnic University and study design. Her goal is to pursue a career in product design. Daisy Thiessen. Daisy plans to take a gap year after graduating, then attend Simon Fraser University to study psychology. Rachel Thompson. Rachel plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley after a gap year. Willow Tyson. Willow plans to attend the University of British Columbia to pursue a career in technical theater. John Tillo. John plans to pursue a career as a paramedic. Tyson Toussaint. Tyson plans to have a very happy and successful life. Nicholas Trasky. Nicholas plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley for his welding certification. His goal is to become a Red Seal welder and millwright. Annika Trithall. Annika plans to attend Thompson Rivers University to pursue a Bachelor of Science focusing on forensic science. I would now like to introduce Ryan Logan to present our last group of graduates.
Okay. I'm honored to introduce the last group of graduates of the night. Caitlin Title. Caitlin plans to attend University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in the agriculture industry as well as getting her professional rodeo card. A big thank you to everyone that has supported me along the way. Cassandra Thiessness. Cassandra is graduating cum laude. Cassandra plans to attend Queen's University to pursue a career in criminal law. Taya Unra. Taya plans to get a tattoo apprenticeship and open her own tattoo parlor. Corbin Upshaw. Corbin plans to earn his chainsaw certification. His goal is to become a certified arborist and work with his cousins. Liam Vanderhoven. Liam plans to become a paid on-call firefighter and keep running my business. Megan Vanderee. Megan plans to pursue a career in language or linguistics. Her goal is to live a happy life in whatever way that ends up being. Cassidy Van Tol. Cassidy Van Tol. Cassidy plans to attend Cosmete Academy to pursue a career in special effects makeup in the movie industry while also pursuing tattoo on the side. Caden Vanderkoy. Caden plans to attend the University of Fraser Valley to pursue a Bachelor of Science degree with a focus on computing science and business. Desiree Van Rietskoot. Desiree plans to travel before returning to school for child education. Sarah Verma. Sarah is graduating cum laude. Sarah plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in medicine. Jax Vidal. Jax plans to go to university and get a business degree. His goal is to own a successful business. Ivania Vielman Hernandez. Ivania plans to attend University of the Fraser Valley. Her goal is to be in the criminal justice program this fall. She would like to thank family and friends for their endless support. Rachel Vignier. Rachel plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in child social work. Her goal is to help children in need. William Voth. William is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. William plans to attend the University of Ottawa to pursue a degree in music. Michael Wagner. Michael plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career as a plumber. Isaiah Walker. Isaiah plans to be a successful and have a happy life. Jada Walker. Jada plans to attend cosmetic college. The goal is to become a professional makeup artist working in the entertainment industry. Jaredon Wheelick. Jaredon is graduating cum laude. Jaredon plans to attend the University of British Columbia to become a biomedical engineer. Kyle Webb. Kyle plans to live life to the fullest and work hard doing so. His goal is to make six figures and become successful by 2025. Eden Waddell. Eden is graduating summa cum laude, an exemplary scholar. Eden plans to continue her education at university and would like to thank her family, especially her mom, for being helpful to find her path in life. Victoria Weeks. Victoria plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in law. Shayla Wegener. Shayla plans to take a gap year to travel her work. Her goal is to find something she is passionate about. Gavin Weicker. Gavin plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to complete his Red Seal in carpentry. Emma Wiesbrod. Emma plans to go to culinary school. Her goal is to become a Red Seal chef. Lily Weeb. Lily plans to travel through different countries to experience cultures and nature around the world. Max Weeb. Max plans to attend university to pursue a degree in business. Ryan Wilkinson. Ryan is graduating magna cum laude. Ryan plans to go to the University of the Fraser Valley to further his education. Cassandra Williams. Cassandra is graduating magna cum laude and exemplary scholar. Cassandra plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley before transferring to the University of Toronto to pursue a career as a book editor. Kelly Williams. Kelly plans to attend a beauty academy. Her goal is to graduate beauty school and learn as much as she can to accomplish her dream. Travis Wolf. Travis plans to start his apprenticeship. His goal is to become a Red Seal automotive technician. Carter Young. Carter plans to attend the University of the Fraser Valley to pursue a career in earth science. His goal is to achieve a bachelor's degree. Angelo Zecca. Angelo plans to attend college to further his education. His goal is to work hard and be successful. Congratulations to the grads of 2023. I'd like to pass it back to Mr. Siggity for some more words.
Well, thank you, Mr. Logan, and thank you to the teachers of Chilliwack Secondary for doing such a wonderful job of introducing the grads. I'm sure you will agree with me that it has been spectacular to witness the success of so many fine young individuals. Please join me again in another round of applause for the graduating class of 2023.
Sardis Secondary. Each year, the graduating class selects the student who they believe can best express their feelings in a farewell address. Okay? To the commencement assembly, it is my pleasure to introduce to you Taylor Bowden. Come on up! The valedictorian of the Sardis Secondary class of 2023.
That's a lot of people. Friends, family, staff, mentors, coaches, community members, supporters, esteemed guests, and classmates. Thank you for being here. I am glad that you are here. I am proud of you, each and every one of you, for having done what it takes to get yourself here tonight. And I'm asking you to please take just at least a moment at some point tonight to recognize for yourself how truly important and incredible an achievement this is. My name is Taylor Bowden. A little bit about me. I'm 18 years old. I love my family and my friends, going for drives to get ice cream at midnight. And it means the world to me to get to stand up here on a stage behind a podium in front of more people than I know and deliver the address for the Sardis Secondary School grad class of 2023.
Now, I'm sure lots of you know this about me, you may have even seen it, but I tend to get a little emotional for big things like this, so you may have to bear with me. Don't worry though, I came prepared. Got my Kleenex, on second thought. This is gonna be big. Now, before I begin, I'd like to extend a most sincere thank you to all of the incredible staff and support in Sardis who have carried us to now. I guarantee you we would not be here without you, and your lasting impact will be forever felt. As lots of you may know, not only are we students moving on tonight, but so are some of the staff who have played such pivotal roles in our careers. I'd like to give mention to Ms. Fitz and Mr. Beagle, two of the most passionate teachers you'll ever meet. Their drive and dedication is something we've all been inspired by, and tonight they deserve so much more than just a round of applause, but it's the least we can do. Now, tonight is a big night for all of us. It's a night for change, for letting go, for moving forward, but most importantly, it's a night for celebration. Now, I don't want to stand here and try to give you all my sage and wise wisdom. I'm in the same boat as all of you. I just happen to have a microphone in front of my face. I just hope to be able to honestly articulate how honored I feel to have gotten to share the best 4 years of my life with you all. To open and to lead me through my speech, I'd like to make reference to one of my favorite books by an author from my childhood, whom I'm sure most of you know, Dr. Seuss. He wrote, "Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. Class of 2023, we did it. We made it. And I'd like to think that we will go down in history as the class that overcame. The last 4 years have been an adventure. I think adventure might be a bit of an understatement. It's really been more of a walk in the park. If the park was on fire, there was intermittent flooding when the park wasn't in flames. You had 4 to 5 full-time classes to be responsible for. And just to top it all off, everyone was catching this hyper-contagious, never-before-seen virus. Our first year of high school, back when we were all just excited to be in a place with 2 floors, science labs, an auto shop, and seniors who were way cooler than us, was cut short. With hardly any warning, spring break morphed into summer, classes morphed into video chats, and life in bubbles morphed into a new kind of normal. For a while, the whole world paused in a weird feeling, unknown sort of way. And what did we do? We overcame. September of the 10th grade, we came back, books in hand, ready for whatever the new year was about to throw at us. Since then, we've taken courses 1 at a time, then 2 at a time. At one point, we were almost back to normal, only for it all to be changed back again. But once more, we persevered, and together, we overcame. That is our story. Through a global crisis, we kept our heads up and pushed through hard times, loss and feeling lost, and managed to navigate a world on hold. And I think it's finally safe to say we've come out on the other side of it. The pride that I feel to be one amongst a group of so many hardworking, driven, perseverant, strong, and absolutely resilient individuals is crazy overwhelming, and I hope you feel it too. Dr. Seuss continued, "You'll be on your way up. You'll be seeing great sights. You'll join the high flyers who soar to high heights. What we have endured, together and in our own lives, is what has made us who we are today. Think about who you were 4 years ago, when you first walked through those big front doors at Sardis, and think about who you are now and how far you've come. That took 4 years of change, and we'll likely all change that much again in the next 4. The wild thing is, we don't just have another 4 years. We've got 5, 10, 25, heck, we've got our whole lives ahead of us. And is it worth it to think about our past? Sure it is. Should we remember it? Of course we should. But is it most important that we take our yesterdays and use them to shape our tomorrows? Absolutely. Our tomorrows will be the result of our yesterdays and even our todays. We will take what we have learned from school, home, and life, and we will overcome time and time again. We will each walk off this stage tonight with one more thing we can use to improve our tomorrows. We can jump from this nest in which we've made a home for the past 13 years, and all by ourselves, we can learn how to be. We can take on the trivial tasks, the massive, scary, crazy big things, and get out of this sheltered fishbowl. We can become who we really are, and it'll be only up to each one of us to determine what that means. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it'll be easy. I'm sure there will be times for all of us when we stumble, when we feel lost, and when it seems like we're doing it all on our own. Good thing Dr. Seuss had a line for that one, too. He said, "And when you're alone, there's a very good chance you'll meet things that scare you right out of your pants. There are some down the road between hither and yon that can scare you so much you won't want to go on. But don't let that stop you. This is the part in each of our stories when it is vital we remember our past, how we overcame, and how we can definitely do it again. This is the part when we remember what I hope you're feeling now: pride, courage, and absolute fearlessness." He continued, "You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the guy who will decide where to go. Now is the time for us to march into the world, scared out of our pants or not, and succeed, or at least just fake it till we make it. We are the future. We are athletes, artists, volunteers, musicians, tradesfolk, academics, and most importantly, we are good people. I believe that every one of us, no matter what anyone says, is a good person. And thanks to a life in high school full of encouragement, laughs, and a whole bunch of really great people, I believe we will stay good people. When we see each other in grocery stores, on social media, or even not until the next reunion, we will say hi. We will know that we have each other's backs, and we will know that we are surrounded by amazing, extraordinary, good people. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Classmates, I could not be more excited to see what the future looks like and all of the amazing things I know we're gonna do. And even when the possible feels like the impossible, when you think all hope is lost, have a little faith in the universe. For oh, the places I am sure we will go. Thank you." Now, classmates, if you'll join me after my count, let's all have one last celebration together, throwing our hats in the air. Congratulations to the grad class of 2023. One, two, three. Thank you.
One more round of applause for Taylor Bowden. Thank you, Taylor. As we near the close of this evening's program, I would like to thank honored guests, parents, relatives, friends, community, and especially the graduates for being part of this special occasion. I would like to acknowledge students Hubna Mukhtar, Alexa Shivi, and Charles Miscabajan, who diligently assisted with the distribution of certificates and roses on stage this evening. To all those who worked behind the scenes, and those who helped make this evening a success, teachers, office staff, support staff, maintenance staff, administrators, and volunteers, many thanks to you. We would like to extend our gratitude to Kim Nickel, Linda Zenzen, and the commencement teams from Sardis Secondary, Chilliwack Secondary, GW Graham, for their hours of planning, organizing, and production of this event.
Well, Kev, this is it. Yep. Congratulations, you did a fine job. Why don't you give him a round of applause?
Yes.
Kevin, yeah.
Thank you.
very welcome. It was a pleasure to do this with you. We have now concluded our ceremony and we'll begin the recessional. Please remain seated as our graduates and honored guests exit the auditorium. So grads from the second row, you will meet in the center and go straight out the back. Thank you very much.